Hello, this is Jennifer Reinhardt. I am on the Dynamics 365 for Financial Support team. And in this video, I'm going to go over the initial setup of the synchronization between Dynamics 365 for Financials and Dynamics 365 for Sales, also known as CRM. The first thing we have to do is make sure we have the appropriate setups before we start the setup. In the main portal page, we have Dynamics 365 here, and we also have admin. We need to go to our admin center and make sure we have two users set up for our connection setup between CRM and Dynamics 365 for Financials. So I'm going to go to users, and right now I have my user. This is the admin user, which I set up Dynamics 365 for Sales and also CRM. So this is my admin user in both applications. So I do need the admin user for CRM, so I know that that's already there. I also need to create another user called an integration user. If I don't create two users and I use my admin user, there will be problems with the synchronization and it won't work properly. So there is a requirement to have two users. So I'm going to go to add user and call it integration user. And my username, integration user, and you can see my domain is the same as my admin. I'm going to create a password and not change the password after logging in. And then I'm going to sign my licenses to Dynamics 365 for Financials and CRM. So this Dynamics 365 for Financials for IWs is the trial. So I'm just using the trial right now, so that's why that is the license I'm giving this user. And once that is done, I can click add. I'm not going to send an email. Close. So here I have my integration user and my admin. So that is all that's needed to be done on the admin center of Office 365. Once that is done, in the Office portal, you can click Dynamics 365, and that will take you to this home.dynamics.com page, which will have both financials and CRM. I am going to go into financials. I've already opened it up, and this is where I can go through the setup of the connection between the two applications. On my home page, I have an assisted setup button on the actions tab. I'm going to click that, and right here, I should see a setup for the CRM connection, but it's not there. So we are missing one thing. So I'm going to close out of my assisted setup. I'm going to click the search icon in the upper right corner and click company, and you should see an option. I'm going to click on company information, and at the bottom, you should see user experience. In order to use the connection between CRM and Dynamics 365 for Financials, you need to be using this suite experience. So I'm going to change this to suite, and I will get a message that you must sign out and then sign in again to have the changes take effect. So I'm going to go ahead and pause the video and do that, and I should be back. Okay, I have logged out and logged back in. And if you're not familiar with logging out and logging in, you click your person icon up at the upper right corner and click sign out, and then it will prompt you to sign back in. All right, so my user experience is now sweet. I'm going to close the company information window. And back in my home page, I'm going to click assisted setup again. And now you can see there is the setup Dynamics CRM connection. So I'm going to click that. The first thing I need to do is enter my CRM URL. It will look something, they give an example here. So you can type in your CRM URL and then click next. The next connection setup is to specify the user for synchronization between the two services. This user will be your integration user. Once that is entered, you can click finish. And the next window will prompt you for the CRM administrator. So that is my user that I set up CRM with in my example. And I click OK, and then the system is going to work on getting this connection ready. Once the connection has been set, the windows will go away and you will be taken back into the assisted setup where you will see the status as completed. I will now close the assisted setup. and we will go back into our home page. And I just want to show you where this connection gets set up at. So again, I'm going to use the search icon in the upper right and type in CRM connection. You should see the Microsoft Dynamics CRM connection setup. I'm going to click. Everything gets set in this window. So this is where we'll see our URL, our integration user, and then the active scheduled synchronization jobs. Also in this window, there are two very important buttons that I use when I'm getting started with CRM. The integration table mappings and the sync job queue entries. So I just want to talk a little briefly about these two. The integration table mappings, if you click that button, you can see the types of integrations that are available. These typically cannot be edited as far as what we are integrating. So at this point, we can't add more things like that. But one thing that I do want to point out in this window is on the very far right side of the window, there is a sync only coupled records checkbox. So what that means is if you have a, let's say, an account in CRM. So you have an account in CRM and you have an account in Dynamics 365 for financials. They are actually the same customer, same account. So if you have them in both locations, you want to couple them, which means kind of match them together. And then this checkbox being marked means that you only want to couple or you only want to synchronize those coupled records, the records that are matched. So if you have a record that's in financials and not in CRM, it won't be synchronized because this checkbox is marked to sync only coupled records. So for my examples, I have a brand new CRM and I'm using a sample company in Dynamics 365 for financials. So I want those things from financials to be created over in CRM. So I don't have records that I can couple. So for me, in my scenario, I am going to unmark all of these because I want everything to be synchronized. Then I'm going to close the integration table mappings window. The next window is the sync job queue entries. In the sync job queue entries, I can see if entries are scheduled, the status will change to error or on hold if something goes wrong or if I set it on hold. And then over again on the far right, there is a number of minutes between runs. If you're going to change things here, best practice is to first set the job queue on hold and then click on the entry you want to change. I'm going to say edit. And I'm going to edit my reoccurrence to be every 2 minutes. And then close, which will save my changes. And then I'm going to restart that synchronization. The other thing to note here, I'm going to do this for the item product as well. I'm going to edit this and change the number of minutes between runs to 2. Also, you can see the earliest start date and time. So if I want this to start immediately, I might change this. My time is currently 9:52, so I might want to change this to 10 a.m. so it runs in 8 minutes rather than waiting until 10:18. So I can also change the earliest start time. So I'm going to close that. And this time I didn't set it on hold, so I'm just going to restart it. That's also an option. So I'm going to continue changing these number of minutes between runs as I want everything to kind of sync up in 2 minutes. I don't want it to take 30 minutes to sync some things up. So I will continue getting that ready. I'm going to close back out of that window just to kind of recap the Dynamics CRM connection setup window and the two buttons that are used often here are integration table mappings and the sync job queue entries. Also in this window, you can test the connection and make sure that the connection is working properly. And here the connection test was successful. The settings are valid. So that concludes the initial setup of the synchronization between Dynamics 365 and CRM. In the next video, I will be showing the actual end result when you create a customer in financials, having that customer create over into CRM and vice versa. So we will be covering that in the next video. Thank you.